Healthy You, sponsored by Ortho Sensi.
With more athletes back on the field, more injuries are now being treated in local doctors' offices.
Medical reporter Liz Bona shares the latest on a common elbow surgery. Liz?
Hey there, everybody. Student athletes and others getting back to baseball may not have been training this pandemic year much in the usual way. So sports medicine specialists at Ortho Sensi now saying one type of injury risk becoming particularly common.
The common injury is, you know, a strain to the forearm muscles, but elbow injuries are kind of gaining a lot more recognition lately, particularly around the inside part of the elbow where the ligament is, the Tommy John ligament particularly.
To fix that, Dr. Michael Grywe says you have to perform what's called Tommy John surgery. If you're not familiar with the history of that.
In 1972, there's a pitcher called Tommy John. His name was Tommy John. And he actually injured his elbow so severely that he was not going to play again. And a surgeon named Frank Job developed a new surgery called Tommy John surgery now, where he reconstructed the ligament on the inside part of the elbow. And Tommy John came back a year later, ended up winning some World Series games, and just was amazing.
Dr. Grywe says because of that, there's sort of a myth among athletes that the surgery makes you better at baseball. In this research of public perceptions of the surgery published by the NIH, where Grywe was one of the lead authors, his team discovered
that the public really believes in some cases that Tommy John surgery is necessary to throw harder or to have better control on their pitches. So about 50% of high school students actually said that they would have Tommy John surgery even if they didn't have an injury so that they could throw better, faster, harder.
As for the real aftermath,
major league players have these injuries and they come back and they throw, you know, really well. And that's not in every case. You know, 82% of patients that have the surgery are successful, but there's a 20% sort of failure rate where they don't come back to their pre-injury levels.
So Dr. Grywe's suggestion, avoid the surgery if possible with proper stretching, coaching, and training.
Now, if you do need some training ideas to prevent this or other elbow injuries, you're invited to reach out to Dr. Grywe's team at whatshappeninginhealth.com. Just click on Ortho Sensi Solutions. Guys?